Hassan Juma is having too much fun in Sao Paulo. I have to admit that. I envy him. Now, the World Cup, it's a big event. It's the world's biggest footballing event. And we shall take a very quick look at some of the interesting facts about the World Cup. Let's start with the fact that the competition has been played every 4 years since 1930, except in 1942 and 1946 because of the Second World War. Brazil, which is the host of this year's World Cup, has won 5 times and has won. Brazil have actually won more than any other team in history, and it is the second time Brazil will be hosting the World Cup. The first time they held the World Cup was in 1950, but they lost in the final to Uruguay. And they have never won the World Cup while hosting it. That was the last time, actually, they held the World Cup in Brazil was in 1950. As I said, they lost to Uruguay in front of 174,000 spectators in the stadium alone. Now, let's look at the budget. It's all about the budget this week, so we shall look at the budget that this World Cup has cost Brazil, $14 to $16 billion. That translates to 1.2 trillion Kenyan shillings. This can easily take care of a very huge portion of the Kenyan budget. And this World Cup is more expensive than the last 3 World Cups combined. The last one in South Africa in 2010 cost about $4 billion. In 2006 in Germany cost about $6 billion. And the previous one before that, which was in South Korea and Japan, cost about $5 billion. You combine all that, comes to about $15 billion. This is much more expensive than all those 3 combined. Now, some of the stadia are still incomplete, which has been a bit of a concern. And by the way, if you have been watching the news and you have been following this story, you will know that there have been protests in Brazil, mostly because this World Cup, and by the way, this figure is going to be way higher than this because of security concerns, the fact that some of the stadia are not complete. This is the amount that has been spent up until now. Let's move on to another subject, which is some of the rules and regulations since the 1930s. An interesting one here. India withdrew in 1950. And the reason that they gave for withdrawing was that, you know, the travel expenses and whatnot. But the Indian captain said that was a cover story. The real story was that FIFA had introduced new rules which ensured that everybody wore boots. In 1948, the Indian team went to the Olympics and they played barefoot. So FIFA came in and said, we cannot have this anymore. So in 1950, they said, new regulations, everybody has to be in playing boots. So 1950, India withdrew. They could not take the pressure of playing in boots. The football is the same size and shape as 1930. This ball has not changed. It is the same round shape and size since the 1930. It changes, the current ball is the Brazuca, which the dynamics of the ball change, but the size and shape have never changed. The goal line technology is going to be used for the first time. Now, what is goal line technology? We have seen a couple of cases where, you know, we're not sure whether the ball has gone into the net whether the ball has crossed the line or not. We're going to have 14 cameras, 7 cameras facing each goal line, which means that every time the ball either crosses or does not cross the line, we're going to have a camera which is attached. All those cameras are going to be attached to one computer mainframe, which then transmits that data to a wristwatch, which is being worn by the referee, and it produces a buzzing sound. And, it just tells the ref whether the ball has crossed the line or not. Let's move on to something else, which is the players. Roger Miller is the oldest player to have ever scored in a World Cup. He was 42 years in 1994 when he scored, and he's also the oldest player to have ever played in a World Cup. If you remember very well, he did a very interesting dance in 1990. Norman Whitesand is the youngest player to have ever played in the World Cup. He was 17 years in 1982, and the player who has had the most appearances is Lothar Matthäus from Germany, who has played in the World Cup 25 times. Ronaldo, the Brazilian one, has scored the most goals with 15 goals. That is yet to be surpassed. phenomenal player. And the fastest goals was by Hakan Sugar from Turkey, which was scored in 2002. And he was playing against Ireland. Yes, he was playing against South Korea in the 2002 World Cup. He scored a goal after just 11 seconds. Just when you're about to blink, he scored. Most iconic goal was Maradona with the hand of God in 1982. I think we have that clip somewhere where Maradona rose to head the ball, but he was a bit too short, so he used the hand of God to help him score a goal against England. Let's see what happened in 1982.